We did not need to show them girls that much. Them girls is out. I did not mean to do that. Ooh, wild hair. Hi. Happy Saturday. It's exactly 4:24 for me. That's an angel number. How is everyone today? I just finished my recording, my very last book club entry for this month for Neville Goddard's Power of Awareness. So I feel amazing. Such a great book. I really suggest it for you guys, anyone that's interested in it. It's a really great book. It's the vocabulary is definitely a little bit older because it was written in the early 1940s, but it's a great book. It's a really great book. It's about the law of assumption, and we love the law of assumption. But, oh, and the dogs are barking. It's Saturday. The little lady, Zoe, is with Dad. So I figured I'd jump on here and say hello to my beautiful babies. And of course, as soon as I sit down here, my cat's like, hey, I can't have your time zone. Also, my Phillies are in the World Series. We love that. That's really exciting for me. I'm a big hometown fan. I'm a Phillies fan. I'm an Eagles fan. I even got my Eagles, you know, they're on my altar. So, because we're 6-0. Hell yeah. I'm not entirely sure what Spirit wants me to do. I just sort of did what I needed to do. And everyone knows that I'm very Spirit led. And away we go. I channel naturally. Fair, your back is itchy. My dog has an itchy butt. He doesn't have worms or anything. It's just, I don't know where these, we've been struggling with fleas. My neighbors have dogs and, you know, we live out in the suburbs. So I don't really know. I'm not entirely sure where they're coming from. And thank you for the follow, Heather. Hi, Charlita. What are you up to today? Hi, James. You're so ready. Good. I think I've just been, you know, I've been struggling like everybody else with this whole eclipse bullshit. Oh, for real? I had no idea that lives kept pausing. That's good to know. Thanks for the heads up. Hi, Regina. We love that. You know, your home is such an important part of your spiritual practice. Really, dog? This is when you want to bark. I swear, everything was calm and collected. And then it was like, oh, mom's going live? All the spirits show up. So then, of course, the dogs go crazy. Hi, Monica. I brushed my hair. I love this. Okay, this is exactly what I felt called to talk about, but I pulled a card just to really confirm the messages that I was feeling and receiving. A leap of faith, follow your dreams, unexpected opportunities. I think what people forget, and what I forget a lot is, you know, faith is not given, it's earned. And that faith is something that we have to really work for. It's not something that we just wake up and we immediately just keep the faith. It's sometimes in the darkest moments, it's when we're tested the most, keeping the faith. Right. I'm really good, Regina. Thank you for asking. Yeah, true, James. And that's the big thing. Faith is everything. I mean, faith goes across religions. It goes across practices. It goes across every society. You know, faith is real. And keeping the faith in your darkest moments is probably part of your biggest test. When the universe wants to know if you mean business, or if you want to test yourself to see if you need business, it's when you've got to really hold on to this notion of keeping the faith. Because, and I've said this so many times, and I really strongly believe in this from the depths of my soul, is that God will absolutely test us in the way of making us confront patterns, making us confront issues or peoples or energies, to make sure, is this something you want to carry with you into the next phase? because we will have a major breakdown or a major mental something, or something's going to happen, you know, in our life, within our soul, or even environmentally, that is going to kind of question our faith. Hi, Casey, how are you? And it's about keeping the faith, and keeping the faith with discipline and devotion. So what do I mean by devotion? It's being devoted to your discipline, being devoted to doing something for yourself every day. Discipline in the sense where, what are you doing? What is your non-negotiables every single day to keep you okay? Hey, listen, nobody said that any of this would be easy, right? You know, like, if it was easy, we would all just be sitting in mansions or mini mansions with Ferraris in the front yard, completely healed, with, you know, Thanksgiving dinner, or, you know, Christmas dinners would go on without a hitch. You know, I would be eternally skinny and I could eat whatever I wanted. I wouldn't have to worry about gaining weight if it were easy, but it's not. And it's not that it's just life. It's just life. And I don't want you to sit here and feel bad for yourselves. And I don't want you to sit here and like, oh, life is unfair. What I want for all of us, myself included, is for us to understand that everything is ours. It's just, we have to keep the faith that we can do it. Because it's not just about keeping a faith in a higher power. It's also about having faith with yourself. Yes, James, exactly. Oh, that's beautiful, Casey. I'm so sorry to hear that, Regina. You know, I've lost a parent. I've lost two parents. And I have a very toxic relationship with my mother. So it's a whole nother loss. You know, it's a whole nother loss. So keeping the faith, even in your darkest moments, through discipline and being devoted to yourself. And I don't want to say it's the key, because it's so cliched and it's such like spiritual buzz bullshit. And we don't do spiritual buzz bullshit, right? we do real world shit in this house. And real world shit, what I mean is things that actually fucking work that anybody can do. And you don't have to be a fucking tarot reader. You don't have to be a psychic. You can just be a normal fucking person and these things will work for you. It is really hard to have faith. It's really hard to have faith when you feel like the world, even though we know the world isn't, but like it feels like the whole world is conspiring against us. And hello, Miss Angie, gorgeous lady. You know, we know that technically the whole world is not conspiring against us, but it sure as fuck can feel that way, right? These cards are so big, and so sometimes they're really hard to shuffle. Okay, we're going to talk about this. The Eight of Air, having the illusion of being trapped. A lack of self-confidence, afraid to take action. You know, it's terrifying to admit to yourself and to swallow that pill of like, ooh, am I the problem? And I think that's been such a theme on TikTok too, with the Taylor Swift song that just came out. Like, it was me. How does that song go? How does it go? Oh, okay. Cool tongue. I mean, I was born in the 80s. And you're... Okay. It's hard to take anybody's criticism or opinion of me seriously when they go to the great lengths of creating a whole false identity on social media and thinking that it's cute and funny. What's even more hilarious is, you know, as a psychic, I can literally sit you sitting behind your phone with greasy skin, you know, unwashed hair with a beer belly, but yet you're concerned about my glasses. No, I'm not wrong. I'm not wrong at all. And I mean, if I hadn't seen my cock in about 6 months because my belly was so big, I'd probably be just as hateful as you. It is what it is. But I send you all the love. Sorry, but there's no spells in the world to make your cock bigger. I apologize. But thank you so much for the entertainment and allowing me to unleash a little bit of my trauma energy on you. And it's my gift to you. So enjoy that negative energy that I've been meaning to cleanse. It's now yours. Enjoy. I mean, you know, energy vampires serve a purpose, guys. So when an energy vampire comes into your space like that, just dump on them. Say, hey, you hungry? Here you go. I mean, I really would be that miserable if I hadn't gotten my cock fucking wet in as long as he has. I mean, my husband gave me the pickle this morning. It's all good. Okay, back to business. Thank you for the plaything, spirit. I enjoyed it. Page of water, intuition, sensitivity, artistic, friendly. A new person enters your life. A relationship begins a new phase. Heightened psychic abilities. You know, it's releasing and letting go of all of those things. I mean, y'all do whatever you want in the comments. I mean, I'm not offended. I'm literally living my best life ever. Anyways, this is about new, you know, a lot of us have been really focusing, and I've seen it on TikTok. Everyone's like, you know, oh, I was too good at protecting my energy, and all of a sudden it's Saturday night and I'm going to bed at 9 p.m. by myself in my pajamas. You know what I mean? I'm like, yeah, you did. But when you make space for beautiful things and you make space for blessings, that's what's going to come to you. Because you've raised the standards, you've raised your level of expectation. And so when you go out into the world and you're looking to really embrace better, you do. Because that's what you're searching, that's what you're manifesting, that's the intention you're putting out in the world, okay? That's what you're doing. You're putting the intention in the world after you've removed all of them, after you remove the tongue punchers. And what you're doing is you're now putting the intention that I am going to surround myself with better people. With, thank you, Monica, for taking care of that. I mean, I hit a nerve. I'm kind of a bit, okay, not kind of, I'm a bitch. Like, I'm a self-proclaimed bitch. And I'm not afraid of calling anybody out like that. And I wounded him. And he deserved it, because sometimes people like them have to learn a lesson that they can't just jump into anybody else's life, certainly not a psychic medium, and they're not going to call them on their bullshit. And that's just the way it is. Okay? So here we are. We're removing toxic people. We're walking away from toxic people. And we're now putting the intention into bringing in better people. Okay? So what we're going to do right now is I'm going to say a quick little cleansing prayer to remove tongue punches energy from the collective, because it's my fault. I poked the beast, but I mean, it was fun. So I'm going to ask Source, God, Creator to come and fill us and this collective and everybody attached to this collective, including your beloveds, your family members, your pets, your children, you know, all of the people that you care about. And I ask you to fill us with love and to fill us with compassion. Okay? And I ask that you release any energy that is no longer serving us and return energy that is not belonging to us, wrapped in love and healing. And so it is. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Listen, it is what it is. It is what it is, guys. But this is, I don't immediately block stuff like that for a reason. Because I always use it as a teaching opportunity to show you guys are absolutely allowed to and are worthy of standing up for yourself and putting people in their place who deserve it. You're absolutely allowed to inflict lessons on people if you choose to, okay? And you're also allowed to then release it, close the door, and move on. And remember that you're probably never gonna see this person again. They don't fucking matter. And they're the ones that are going to lose sleep over this moment, because you win. Absolutely. It's important to put people in their place. And because I look at it like this. I look at it like this and I take this very seriously. Not everybody has the balls that I have. Not everybody has the mouth that I have. And if I can make that person or that troll second guess whether or not to harass or poke anybody else, then I did my job. Because when consequences are not implemented on individuals like that, who think they can say whatever they fucking want because their life is so fucking despicable and pathetic and horrible, then what happens is they become a pariah of society. And so it's important for people, exactly, accountability, like myself, who are not afraid. It's why the Druze of the world, who put men in their place for being nasty and horrible, it's important to have people like us, because otherwise these people run around and they're rampant and they literally are grotesque and horrible and they're hurtful and they're hurting people. So it's important for us to stand up and tell them, absolutely not, you little fucker. And now, more than likely, the next time he pops, or he might second guess whether or not to talk shit about someone in the future. Because we're in a patriarchal system. And the patriarchal system is probably a, you know, palm-colored individual who his whole life has been taught that just being white makes you better and superior to everyone else. So what happens is he immediately doesn't have to worry about being talented or amazing, but he expects that he can just be a fucking hurtful piece of shit because he's better than everybody else. I don't play that. We all have to understand. Here's the thing about divine feminine, guys. The divine feminine is not just nurturing. She's also fiery and a warrior. We are both, and both of them are inside of us. And we are not honoring our divine feminine energy if we do not embrace both. Villain era is bullshit. And I'm going to tell you why. Because it's the patriarch telling women that you are being villainous by having boundaries. I love my glasses. He can go suck my dick. Like, literally, my proverbial dick. You know what I mean? And so they're telling us, oh, you're a villain because you're a feminine energy who wants to have boundaries and to stand up for themselves. So immediately, it's the villain era. Bitch, no, it's not. This is my divine feminine energy, my goddess energy, that's showing you that we, as the divine feminine, and that has nothing to do with your physicality, your genitalia, or any of that. And it has everything to do with your divine feminine energy and who you are in here. And we are goddesses, and we are warriors, and we are mothers and nurturers. We are priestesses. And understand that. You are not a villain, you are a goddess. What would Aphrodite do? Thank you. Aphrodite would eat that motherfucker alive. She would make him fall in love and then eat him alive. Thank you, Angie. Exactly. What would Cleopatra do? You know, you don't have to work with gods and goddesses. Oh, that's dope. That's really cool. I haven't seen that before. What would they do in that situation? If some little peasant, some nobody little man came in there, she would eat him the fuck alive. She would eat them alive and spit about, and she would make an absolute mockery of them. Because as women or divine feminine energy or goddess energy, especially somebody in my position where I have 160,000 people who are following me and are, you know, connecting with my energy, I have a responsibility to protect you. The Ten of Earth. Thank you guys. I love you guys. A very happy family life, financial security, finding magic in the little things. And somebody mentioned this. Somebody mentioned this, and I wonder, if it was you, please say something. And thank you if you guys, thank you. If this is resonating with you, or if this is something that you guys want to talk about, and this is just feels right to you, and I'm going to talk about this a little bit more in the future, but your spiritual practice should feel like you're breathing. It's normal. It shouldn't be forced. It should be like, this is me. And if when I do this and when I embody this energy, it feels like I'm breathing. I'm no longer numb. How many of you have felt numb? I love it. Put the number one in the chat right now if you feel me. If you feel me. How many of you for the longest time have felt numb? And for the very first time in a long time, maybe you're starting to feel. Feel. I want you to feel my power. I want you to know that that same power, that same divine feminine energy is inside of you. But the more you allow others to tell you right now that you are not allowed to protect yourself and that you are not allowed to be a fiery presence and you're not allowed to be both nurturing and beautiful and amazing and a businesswoman and an angel guide, you have all of that inside of you right now, just like I do. It's just understanding and embracing the simple fact that you too are special and you too are unique. How many of you, and put the one in the chat again, if for the longest time, and it's 4:44 right now as I say this, how many of you look at me as an inspiration? I am just like you. And how many of you look at me right now at 4:44 and they're like, I could never be like her. I could never be like her. And what I'm telling you is you can. I'm telling you is you can. And it all starts right here, believing yourself, believing in the simple fact that you have this beautiful, beautiful divine light, this spark inside of you right now. And I get really excited about this stuff because I told myself and I sat here before I got up here and I prayed to God and I said, God, I want to get on here and I want to change people's lives. I want them to feel, connect to my energy right now. I want you to really feel this. Because I do have these insane fucking gifts and I don't always understand them. But there's one thing I know, that when you connect to my energy, you will feel the fucking power. You will feel the fucking fire inside of you right now. And guess what? We all have it. It's about embracing the simple fact that you're allowed to be powerful. You're allowed to be powerful. For too long, how many of you have been told, bitch, shut the fuck up and be quiet and be beautiful. And put a face, not to say, do your makeup, feel beautiful, but feel beautiful without it. How many times have you been felt like, you know what, I have to go to these great fucking lengths just to, or I have to work twice as hard as my male counterpart. It's okay, because they're caught up in the emotion, it's all good. It's all good. You guys can tap afterwards. It's all fine. Because that's, you know what? Honestly speaking, take this energy in because I'm flowing it to you. This is coming from God. This is coming from source right now. And I want you all just to receive. Say out loud right now, I receive, I receive, I receive. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Because it's coming from here. Part of the reason why your girl has been so fucking quiet is I've been doing the work. Because I want to serve myself so I can serve all of you. I went through a phase for a while where I was like, I don't know what I want. I didn't know if I was ready. And I told God, and I told God, and I was like, I'm ready. I said, God, I'm ready. I'm fucking ready. I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm fucking ready. And what did God do? He fucked my whole world up. And I say he because I'm used to saying he, but take it whatever resonates. And God was like, okay, bet. Well, you've got to remove all these people, and you've got to stop doing this, and you've got to start doing that. And I did it. And I did it. That's a them problem, Yari, not a you problem. I'm gonna say it again. That's a them problem, that's not a you problem. And if you're gonna have to pop off on them, guess what? That's your God-given right. God was testing. And I told God, and I said to God, I'm gonna talk about you. I meant it when I said, because how many times have you caught, I'm going to ask you a question. How many times, and I'm sure all of you can relate to this, within the last year, have you been laying in bed and you've just been crying and you said, God, make it stop, make it stop. God, make it stop. I'm so tired of being sick and fucking tired. I did it so many times. And I remember the very last time I did it. I do. It was one of those cries that it was like, it probably woke up in every ancestor. You know what I mean? Like every single one. And ever since that moment, I've had so many opportunities where I could have just crawled back in bed and I could have just been like, I can't do this. But embrace the existence of God however you want, whatever works for you. And this is what I was talking about before with faith. You know, in your darkest moment, having faith in your higher power. Even when you can't see the light, it's believing that it's there. Even when you don't believe that the end of the tunnel will ever come, it's knowing that it will. That's faith. And you have to work and you have to do it every single day. Whether it's with affirmations, whether it's meditation, whether it's going to the gym, whatever it is with your discipline and your devotion to yourself and filling your soul every day. You guys, this is an everyday thing. This is where the discipline comes in. This is an everyday thing. Every single day, you have to work towards this, the 10 of earth, and that is happy life. That is, what little thing am I doing for myself right now so that I can achieve the end goal? And the end goal, you're welcome, the end goal should always be peace, happiness. And then we start to work on the details. Well, what's going to make you happy? I don't know what is in my hair. So I always do this. It's so funny. This is candle wax. Like I fiddle with candles. Like I dig my fingers in the candles. And then it's being honest with yourself about what you really, really want. And then it's believing in yourself that you can actually go do it. And here's the thing, you don't need to know all the answers. And here's, you know, one thing I really learned in my journey, and this is all stuff me talking about my life and sharing my life with you guys, is I don't know what I'm going to be or what I want to be in 6 years. I don't know. But I know who I want to be at Christmas. Christmas is attainable to me. Christmas is like 2 months away. Like, I know who I want to be at Christmas. I want to be, you know, and I know that by being that and by striving for that goal, I will find happiness. I literally just got an affirmation. It goes, I deserve a life full of love. The problem is everybody talks about dream big, dream big, dream big, but then people lose sight of what dreaming big really is. Dreaming big is happiness, joy, peace. Okay, that's dreaming big. But then you have to work out the details, because the details are just important. The business of details is just as important as the big picture, right? Okay, so details are, what is going to make you happy? What is something you can obtain that you know within 3 months or 2 months, whatever Christmas is for you, you're going to be happy? So for me, 20 pounds lighter, and I'm going to water aerobics 3 times a week. I downloaded my Fitness Pal and I looked up my goal weight, and eating for my goal weight every single day, you know, the certain amount of calories I would have to eat to maintain that. Okay. And a home full of love. And what does that look to be? You know, a Christmas brisket, you know, a Christmas tree and presents under the tree, and watching my children get all excited about waking up. And that is what I aspire for this Christmas. Those simple little things. Those simple little things, those little details. And then the gratitude of it all. Waking up and just feeling so incredibly blessed and grateful that God delivered. Yeah, I love it. And it's been such a, you know, and the other thing is my health back. You know, I'm 40 years old and I just found out that I'm pre-diabetic and that I've got high blood pressure. So we're working through it. And to me, it was like a real wake-up call from spirit. Like, girl, you're going about this all the wrong way. You're worried about the outside stuff and not the inside stuff. So I'm not going to keep going, because I feel like this, I just want what I said right now in the last 30, 40 minutes. I want you to take it and run with it. I want you to sit there and think to yourself, who do I want to be in a month? Who do I want to be in 2 months? And what can I do right now in the next 2-3 hours that can make you happy. For me, I woke up this morning after my husband gave me incredible lovin's, and I made biscuits from scratch. Because that's his love language, and it brought me so much joy to watch him just eat that and be happy in filling him with love. And that's the goal. My goal is every single live, I want to peel back a layer so you can get closer to you, which brings you closer to God. I do have a patron. We have a book club. We have a whole ass book club. And in the patron, what you get, which is really dope, every single day I pull an oracle card and give you an affirmation. And then we're just about to start the new book, and you don't even have to buy the book. It's really fucking cool. Is I, you know, break it down. Because how many times do you buy these great books on from TikTok? You know what I mean? And you don't read them. They go on a shelf. Absolutely. The link is in my bio. It's only $9 a month, but every single day you get an oracle card and an affirmation. You also get connected to a private Facebook group, and every Thursday is book club, where I open up a Zoom for about an hour and we all just, I give free readings. I just do what I do here, but you're in a group of like under 10 people at this point. Yeah, book club is everything. It's so much fun. We haven't done that book. We've done 4 books. I just finished the last one today. It's uploading right now. We've done Happy Home, where we all learned the basics of Feng Shui. And what's cool is you can join at any time. And all of those books are in the patron. And you can do whichever book you want whenever you want. We did Kyle Gray's Raise Your Vibrations, which we all loved. Right? I loved that one. And we did The Magic, which was written by Rhonda Burns, who did The Secret. And then I just finished Neville Goddard's Power of Awareness. And now we're going to do Rise, Sister, Rise. That makes me so... And that's why I do what I do. And that's what I do. And we've got so many other books lined up that we're like, I'm just excited, you know? A lot, you know, and then a lot of people will buy the book too. And they follow along on their own and they take their little notes and, you know, they save it for later. Or, you know, I talked to Brittany. She's in group. And she was like, girl, you do know that I don't read the books. I just listen to you. She goes, I buy the books, but I... Hey, whatever works. Well, this is book club for lazy people. This is literally book club for lazy people, because it's like, honestly speaking, like book club on Thursdays, we don't always really talk about the book unless there was something that really happened in the book, like that really hit a lot of us. But, and then a lot of people are doing different books at different times. It's more just about building a community. It's about, you know, just being there for each other. You know what I mean? It's about really just being there for each other. And there's like people on different levels of their spiritual community. You know, there's a few people in there who do mediumship. There's people in there that are just learning that they're an empath. It's just such a dope little environment. Like if you, it's like this, but y'all, like I put you to task. And but the thing is, I am going to say this, there's a disclaimer. I will expect you to be vulnerable and I will expect you to open up. Yeah, this literally, and that's what this next month's book is all about, you know, sisterhood and community. And that's what this really is. It's really exciting. And we have women from all over the country so far. It's really cool. And the disclaimer though is I will expect you to be vulnerable. I will expect you to open up, because if people are going to feel comfortable and safe to really do the inner child healing, to really do the mother wound and really deal with their shit, they need to feel safe. And if they don't like you feel comfortable enough or safe enough to open up yourself, it's not going to be a safe environment for everybody, because how can they trust you? How can you trust people in the group if you're not willing to trust them? It's a two-way street. And so I'm very, very vulnerable in there. I'm very, very honest. And so is everyone else. If you're ready, this isn't so much about, it's about spiritual development, but it's really about healing. Because through healing is how we develop spiritually. Sorry, there's really no way around it. If you want to be a really amazing medium and a really great psychic medium or tarot reader or healer, you got to heal. You got to do the work. There's no way around it. It is what it is. But yeah, links in my bio. I mean, you can't beat $8.99 a month. You might want to wait. If you're going to join, what I would say is wait until November 1st. Otherwise, you're going to be billed for, like, the last 3 days of the cycle. You know what I mean? Unless you don't care and you just want to tip me. We love that. But yeah, you wait till November 1st because that's when they bill. But you would get billed for the rest of October as well. But either way, I mean, hey, I'll buy my kids some tacos. Kids love tacos. I love you guys. I really do got to run because it is Friday or Saturday. And the little one already ran up here. And yeah, but I'm really excited about book. I just love book club because it's like my therapy as well. And it keeps me on point to read every week or, you know, every day. Yeah. So here's the thing. Oh, yay. Thank you, Monica. I'm so happy to have you. The whole point is look at it like this, guys. I'm like your personal trainer. Like, how many times have you bought books, especially spiritual books or stuff that people suggest on TikTok for everyone to read? Like, this was one of them. And, you know, you buy the book and then you put it on the shelf and then you never, ever touch it again. Yes, happy Halloween. Go play with the spirits. They're out having a party just like us. Nothing to be afraid of. It's just a whole vibe. Everyone's just vibing. The spirits are out there vibing. They probably just want some candy or to smell the candy. Y'all, go watch the TV show Ghosts. It's so funny to me. It's on CBS, maybe? With, I don't know. It's so good. They buy a bed and breakfast. The chick falls down some stairs, almost dies. All of a sudden, she can see all the ghosts that live in this old, old mansion. Yeah, I think it's really funny. Well, it's one of those shows I watch with my husband. So, like, you know, by that time, I've had a couple glasses of wine. That's just me being real. You know what I mean? I love you. I gotta go. I can hear my daughter freaking out. You guys, if you missed anything, this will be on YouTube probably by tomorrow. I do post all of my lives on YouTube. It's funny. It's on Amazon Prime or Hulu if you want to catch up with it. Because it's just so funny. Just check it out. It's just so good. And it's not even like in a spooky sense, like in a witchy way. It's just funny. Okay. I love you guys. Bye.